Dr. Will Kuhn, Director of Science and Research at Discover Life in America, and I'm excited today to talk to you about the Smokies ATBI. So I'll tell you about the ATBI and what it is, give you some highlights from this 23-year ongoing project, and in the end, I'll give a plea for your help. We need help doing some things with this project. And just to let you know, all of the information that I'm giving you today will be available at dlia.org/entomology2021. So feel free to look it up there after the presentation. So as I said, Discover Life in America is a nonprofit. We are one of four nonprofit partners of Great Smoky Mountains National Park. And we work in this beautiful place. The Smokies is just gorgeous. It is on the Tennessee-North Carolina border of the eastern U.S., and it's over 800 square miles of this mountainous terrain that ranges from close to sea level all the way up to several peaks that are above 6,600 feet. The park gets enough rain that it is considered a temperate rainforest, particularly the higher elevations of the park. And it's the only temperate rainforest in the eastern US. It also has some really incredible geology, a diversity of geology, of geological features, and rocks that date back almost a billion years old. There's also quite a few vegetation communities in the park, and these each have their own kind of biodiversity associated with them. And so for all these reasons and more, this is an extremely biodiverse place. It's a biodiversity hotspot filled with so many kinds of plants and insects and lots of other organisms. But this biodiversity is also under threat by things like development that's kind of encroaching on the park, the gateway communities to the park on either side are growing bigger and bigger every day. There's also air pollution from cities as far away as Atlanta, which is several hours' drive from the park. And invasive species from things that range from wild hogs that were brought in by European settlers to more recent invasives like kudzu, which covers lots of the trees outside the park, and the hemlock woolly adelgid that's killed a lot of the hemlocks in the park. And of course, there's also climate change, which is increasing the frequency of crazy weather events in this case caused a wildfire, but also do lots of other damage to the park and are slowly increasing the temperature, which particularly affects the higher elevation flora and fauna in the park. And so I don't think I have to argue with this crowd that this biodiversity is worth conserving and that we should know something about it. So back in 1998, the park established our organization to carry out and manage this massive project called the All Taxa Biodiversity Inventory, which is nothing less than an effort to catalog every single species that lives in the park. And we seek to answer kind of four key questions with the ATBI. So first of all is what species actually live in the park, but we also want to know things like where and when those species occur across the park. How common or rare are they? Are they endemic? Are they sensitive? Are they endangered? And perhaps most importantly, how do these species actually interact with each other? And so the way that we do this, that we undertake the ATBI, is through some different facets. So we conduct our own biodiversity sampling in the park. We also work with researchers who are doing their own biodiversity work in the park. We partner with the National Park Service to help them with inventory and monitoring projects. And we also leverage park visitors, volunteers, to become community scientists and to help us learn more about the park. And in turn, we try to engage our community to know more about and to really care about the biodiversity here. So in the last 23 years, we have more than doubled the number of species known to the park from around 9,600 before 1998 to now more than 21,000 species. And maybe most astoundingly, 1,045 of these, and that number slowly ticks up every couple of months, are actually species that were described from material collected in the park. So over 1,000 of these species are new to science. But we think this 21,000 number is actually, we have a long ways to go. We estimate there are 60 to 80,000 species in the park. So we're maybe a quarter to a third of the way by that estimate. It's still a lot to discover. So just looking at a breakdown of the biodiversity in the Smokies, almost half of the species in the Smokies are insects, 47%. There's also, as I said, quite a bit of plant diversity and a lot of fungus diversity. And this includes the lichens. There's over 900 different species of lichens in the park. Looking at just the arthropod diversity, beetles, not surprisingly, make up about a quarter of the arthropod diversity, but they make up 12% of all biodiversity in the park, which is pretty incredible. Flies as well are extremely diverse here, Lepidoptera, and Hymenoptera as well. And we think some of these groups, particularly the Hymenoptera, the parasitic wasps in particular, we think are vastly understudied. So this this plot may look a little bit different in another few years. And that brings me to a plea for your help. We need help identifying the organisms that we found in the park. So a lot of these organisms are posted to iNaturalist. We have an iNaturalist project for the park that has now over 70,000 observations, somewhere around 4,000 different species. These include all life, but there are quite a lot of different arthropods here, and we need help identifying them. And so one example of what this could look like is for this bee species Epiolus inornatus, the cellophane cuckoo bee. It's super cute and it has a neat story. So back in 2019, we were conducting a bio blitz to look at how the biodiversity was recovering a few years down from a wildfire in the park. And we found this bee species. We posted some diagnostic images on iNaturalist. And lo and behold, it was identified by Thomas Onoferco, who actually had described that species just a couple years earlier, which is pretty neat. So this is a new species record for the park. We also have a lot of galls, leaf miners, leaf rollers, and other insects and arthropods that use leaves and plants in these different ways. All six of these species here are new species records for the park, and they were all identified through iNaturalist, which is pretty cool. But if you're not into that, there's lots of leaf litter arthropods. Mike Catarino and his group regularly post these amazing photos of beetles and Calimbula and other leaf litter arthropods that they sift from high elevation forests. And even if you can't get these down to the species level, which is obviously very difficult from just one or two images, even getting it down to genus can be very helpful for us. We found quite a lot of new genus records this way. So another thing you can do is to fill out a survey about your taxon of interest in the Smokies. So to explain, we have a project where we're trying to estimate the quote unquote completeness of the ATBI. We realize that it will probably never be complete, but we can get to a more complete place. So as I said, we estimate there are 60 to 80,000 species living in the Smokies, but that's just an estimate. And we'd like to hone it using ATBI data. We also would like to find and continue to prioritize work on understudied taxa in the park. And the way we're doing this is by applying some statistics to existing ATBI data to kind of model how many more species are taxon by taxon are likely to be in the park, and also by surveying taxonomists. So we have a short survey that walks the survey taker through kind of an analysis of their taxon in the park. And basically it gets them to estimate what's missing from our species list for that taxon, and also to highlight additional research, some more specifics about what kind of additional research needs to be done to quote unquote complete this taxon in the park. And we have a list of priority taxa that are in need of, that we need survey takers for, and I'll show that in a minute. So another thing you can do to help us is to identify material from the Smokies. We have a huge backlog of material that's been collected over the years, using malaise traps, Lindgren funnels, pitfall traps, hand collecting, et cetera. And we recently inventoried it, and it's around 500,000 specimens. And over half of those are flies. We have lots and lots of flies that we need help identifying. A lot of these specimens are in alcohol. We're working on a volunteer program where volunteers will help us kind of pin and roughly sort this material. There's also quite a lot of Hemiptera, particularly hoppers, and lots of wasps and some other groups as well. So we need help identifying that. And you can also visit the natural history collection. There's definitely some identification work that needs to be done in the collection. And it's housed in this beautiful building, the Twin Creeks Science and Education Center, on the Gatlinburg side of the Smokies. And lastly, you can conduct your own biodiversity research in the Smokies. We've got information about the lodging available and workspace available, how to navigate research permits, and we can get you in contact with park folks, what kinds of ATBI and other biodiversity data are available from the park, and information about the lots and lots of maps and GIS data that are available for the Smokies. And as I said, we have a list of priority taxa that we particularly would like more survey work to be done with. But the park also maintains a list of research topics, questions that they would like answered. And those are all available on our information for scientists page on our website. So here is just a quick look at this priority taxa list. I'm not going to read through it, but just to say that there's a lot of work that needs to be done. We have a larger version of this list on our website that lists specifically what kinds of tasks need to be done for each of these groups. For some of them, we need a survey taker. Some of them, we consider them understudied and they need more biodiversity study. Some of them have a large backlog of specimens that need identifying, et cetera. And we do have some funding available particularly for ID work and for biodiversity studies. And these are in the form of mini grants, what we call mini grants. They're usually about $1,000 to $3,000 in size. And they are, the size of those grants is based on kind of our current funding availability, which varies over time, and the size of the task at hand. So there's more information about that at our Information for Scientists page. And I just want to give a couple of plugs. So one is that we have a really fun, really neat summer internship program where we hire usually three undergraduates to come help us do work in the park, to learn about how nonprofits work, and just to immerse themselves in the Smokies. So our application is available on our website, and more information about that. And also for this group, we have a synchronous Firefly fundraising event that we hold outside the park, but adjacent to the park. And it's in June. And it's just a really neat event. It's kind of an exclusive look at the synchronous fireflies, blue ghost fireflies, another kind, and lots of other cool glowing organisms. So our website is where you can find tickets and information about that. And lastly, I just want to say, come see us at our booth. We have a booth in the exhibit hall, and you can come talk to us, find out more about the ATBI. But if you're not here in person, feel free to look us up at dla.org/entomology2021, where I've got all the resources that I talked about in this presentation listed there. And we're also on social media. So thanks for tuning in and have a great day.